something about this. It's like, for example, when you mentioned a driver, one means the driver having committed a crime or like the accident, who was consciously in his right mind or who was driving. Sadly, such kind of thing wouldn't have happened. So maybe he was using drugs, he was on drugs, or he was a drunk, or he was driving late night and he didn't know what to stop, and that's when the crime committed. But if we don't put an example, if we don't set an example to people, so they're gonna be thinking like it's normal. When somebody just kills someone and walks away and you just take them to jail. For example, now in our country, in jails, the commuters, the coppers, they teach them other things, the skills they have. Whenever they learn, they try to change them. They teach, just like you mentioned, to change them, they teach them to correct themselves. And then, but those people have no idea, have no clue what kind of damage they have put to that person, the other family beside. They have responsibility, they have anything to cover up. But what about the person that's lost his life? What about that person? Doesn't he have a family? Doesn't he have a job? Doesn't he have any kind of responsibility to cover? There are a lot of children, a lot of parents that really need help from the person that they have lost. They're carrying a huge pain inside them. But because somebody just brushed that off and say that, yes, I did this. I have been in prison for 10 years or 12 years, but here I am. He doesn't know what he's done. And the other people, they will be just like, yeah, I'll just disappear for 10 years old, blah, blah, blah. And I'll be going like in a jail and I'll come up. That's what they take it. Because they don't think that having to put an end to, and you have also mentioned about human rights. Yeah, we are all given a right to live. But who will give you the right to take away that person's life? That person's life while you were defending your own life. That's not fair. And then, that's not right. So every crime should be put a limitation to stop it from it to happen next time. Because if you don't tell them that it's not right, it's wrong, and put an end to it before it actually gets serious, it actually belongs and people keep on doing it over and over again, we have to put a restriction on that. We have to stop it. Because if somebody doesn't, for example, take our country, like, they're still alive. Oh my God, they're still alive. They rob you, they break into a house, whenever you're going in abroad, they still, they do a lot of crazy things. But there's nothing in action taken on that. And then everyone,